Hi there, I'm Mike. What I have for you today is my part two of my checklist for Star Wars the Black Series figures. As you can see up here on the top, I've got my phase one out of their boxes and on my shelf. I've got some other figures that I've recently received that I have not reviewed yet. I hope to get to those soon, but I want to get things out and on my shelves, so I'm doing these checklists because it's the easiest time to do them. People seem to have liked my phase one checklist. So, phase two, let's get into it. Phase one ended endish of 2014, and phase two started around the same time. It started with a new box design, started with a renumbering from one, where the phase one left off at 14, which was the 13th figure. And then phase two ended in September of 2015 when it rolled over to phase three with Force Friday. Don't remember if that was September 1st or September 30th, but it was somewhere around there. Number one of phase two is this figure. This is a Sand Trooper figure. Now, it's a little different from the Sand Trooper we got before, which is up here. It was number four in phase one. This one is, it's all black. The pauldron is all black, and the weathering is a little different from that. Other than that, though, he came with the same accessories. He's basically the same figure with a slightly different deco. Now, I had to look it up because I have no idea what the colors mean, but the all black is a corporal, according to the one website that I looked at. I don't know if that's accurate or not. I'm sure if it's not, there's someone out there that will correct me. I'm a sucker for troops and troop builders. However, I typically don't troop build. So I was happy when they started making alternate versions of these because it gave me a reason to buy another one without feeling like I was buying another one. So now I've got an orange one. And I've got a black one. Well, you know, the pauldron is orange and black, not the actual, I have no idea what race the, anyway, that's the difference. And that's number one. Now, just quick packaging design, you can tell the difference here. It's a lot more open in the front. You can see the whole figure, which is nice. You can pretty much see the whole figure before, but there's definitely a lot more. We still have the all black drawn version of the character here on the bottom. Down here, everything's blue, where on the last one it was orange. It's still black because it's the Black Series as far as the box is concerned. On the back, we have this blue stripe running down. We still have kind of a drawn black and white. It's probably just a real picture that they put through a filter. And then we still have a little blurb up here. It seems to be a little bit more. On the phase one boxes, they had a quote from that character. On the phase two, they have a little kind of blurb for it and also a quote. So we get a little bit more. So again, I'm not gonna spend this much time on every box, but I wanna show off the differences between the boxes because there are some between phase one and phase two. So moving on to one of the most disappointing figures in the entire line, Darth Vader. Oh man, I was so looking forward to this. When they showed off pictures of him, all the cloth cape, the multi-parted helmet, he comes with his lightsaber, but the I have some little issues with this. First of all, anyone that tells you the helmet looks weird, it does. It looks like a sad puppy dog helmet. It's a weird sculpt, it's a sad sculpt. The cape is too big, it's too long, and there's no place to hook on the lightsaber. Like, Darth Vader puts his lightsaber on his belt. He should have it there. But you know, it's definitely an Empire Strikes Back slash mostly a Return of the Jedi Darth Vader. It was a good addition. I was very excited for it, but it was definitely disappointing. Moving on to number three, we have another disappointing figure. Now, phase two, I think overall, I feel like there are more bad figures than good figures in phase two. Phase two is definitely, in my opinion, the huge dip in quality. This is another figure when they announced I was looking forward to. Jedi Luke goes with the Return of the Jedi Darth Vader that they had. I think the face sculpt is okay. I know a lot of people don't. His hair is a little too dark, maybe. They could have done so many things here. But he's got a weird accessory. First, this chest piece is removable so that you can put on this part with the white under, which, you know, symbolizes, oh no, he was good the whole time underneath. The inside is white, guys. You know, because he had both looks, and it's cool that you give him the option. I don't know, there's just so many different things that you can think of accessories, but he does come with an alternate chest, which is weird, and then his lightsaber, which is fine. You know, it's good. It's a good accessory. But I think a lot of people are pretty disappointed by that figure. I'm not so much, but it's definitely not the best. I'll admit that. The last figure in wave one of phase two of the Black Series was the figure that was supposed to come out in phase one. They even had pictures of him in the box, but for some reason they delayed him, and now we got Chewbacca. He's number four now instead of, I think, 13 that he was gonna be in phase one. He's definitely big. I think he might be a little too big, actually. There's some other issues I have with this figure, but overall, he's pretty good. I don't like that his mouth is permanently like in an open, and it's hard to make his bowcaster fit into his hands and his bowcaster since it comes apart in the package. It wants to fall apart all the time. And his bandolier strap wants to fall down all the time. It just constantly slips down his shirt like a bra strap. So it's not a perfect figure, but it's definitely, like, it's a good one, I guess. It looks good next to Han Solo. That was the end of Wave 1. Wave 2 came out the tail end of 2014. I picked this up at Toys R Us, RIP. Toys R Us. So there were four figures that came out in Wave 2. Starting with number 5, one that I was looking forward to a lot is the TIE Fighter pilot here. The TIE Fighter pilot is a design that I've really loved. I've always liked the helmet. He's a plain but good figure. Like, he's exactly what he's supposed to be. I kind of wish they would make a TIE Fighter that went along with this. Like we got the First Order one, but I want one that, you know, is more original trilogy, that's all. He does come with a gun, a blaster, and he comes with a holster for that blaster to fit in, which is neat, I like that. I couldn't honestly think of anything else he should come with, because the only time you see these guys, they're in a TIE fighter, sitting down. So I've never even seen one use a blaster, but it's cool that he came with that. It'd be weird if he didn't. So this is one of those that only comes with like the one thing, and I guess I'm okay with that. Number 6, moving right along, is one of my least favorite figures in the entire line. And that's Yoda. Again, this whole phase 2 is gonna have some stinkers in it. First of all, he's the same price as the others, and he's like this friggin' big. Number 2, he's got like no articulation whatsoever. It is cool that he comes with the snake as like a nod to the original, you know, Empire Strikes Back toy. He comes with his lightsaber, in case you want more of like a Revenge of the Sith, or I guess Attack of the Clones Yoda, but he definitely doesn't look like that in the face. And he comes with a walking stick, which is okay, I guess. I usually leave the snake in the package, and I leave the lightsaber in the package, and I have his cane in his hand, so he's just, you know, old man Yoda from Empire Strikes Back. I'm not a fan of his face. I don't think his face is all that great. I wish that this figure was better. I think it was an okay attempt, but the execution really kind of, it was a disappointment for me. And then the number 7, moving right along, is a repaint from the clone trooper that we got before. This is the clone trooper sergeant. He's green. He comes with the exact same accessories as the plain clone trooper from phase 1, but he's got, you know, the sergeant colors, the green stripes and all that stuff. Because in the phase 1 clone troopers, which is what this is, the phase 1 clone trooper, they denoted rank with color, as opposed to phase 2 clone troopers where colors were based on your squad, which I think is a cooler kind of thing, so you can see what squad everyone kind of looks like they belong to a certain squad. But he comes with the same kind of accessories, but I'm okay with that. Again, like I said before, I'm super okay with repaints on troopers. It gives me a reason to buy another one. And clone troopers, stormtroopers, those are things that there were a lot of, so any excuse to buy multiples is good. Now, I only saw this guy in the store once when I bought it, and because I saw the whole wave sitting on the shelf, and so I'm glad I picked it up when I did, because I would have never seen it again. The last figure on Wave 2, Phase 2, number 8, I don't have it because it's Obi-Wan Kenobi. It's the exact same Obi-Wan Kenobi from Phase 1. It's the Revenge of the Sith one, and I couldn't bring myself to buy it just to have the number completed. It was like the first figure where I was like, I feel like I should buy it. Like, it actually tore at me. I saw it so many times because so many people didn't buy it because they got the one from phase 1. Like, why would you buy it in phase 2 if you got it in phase 1? Even as a completionist like myself, I was like, I'm not an in-the-box completionist. I'm a figure completionist. I want each representation of the figure. But I've got that. I got it in phase 1. So I just didn't buy it. I even saw one hanging out at Walgreens. It was on sale for like 10 bucks. Still didn't buy it, I couldn't. Now, the next two waves, I never saw in stores ever. I had to order them on Entertainment Earth. Luckily, I ordered them as like entire packs, so it was pretty easy, but it was annoying. It was annoying to say the least. Starting with number 9, Han Solo in his Stormtrooper gear. Now it's another Han. Now, at this point, the line was only like a year old. You know, it started in 2013, actually 2 years old. So it started in 2013, this came out like early 2015, middle of 2015. And this is only the second Han Solo that came out. So it's not so bad, but you know, it's A New Hope when he's in his Stormtrooper outfit. And it's basically, as far as I can tell, it's literally just a Stormtrooper body with a Han Solo head and a removable helmet. I don't like removable helmets. I wish that you could just swap heads. I think it cuts down on paint wear on the face. I feel like proportions can look a little better. I don't know, because even though, yeah, you really put a helmet on your head, they always have to make the helmet a little bit bigger because it's plastic and not, you know, it doesn't just slide on. What I usually do is I put the helmet on him and put him with the rest of my Stormtroopers, because underneath you can't tell that he's Han Solo when he's wearing it. So I usually use him as a troop builder. kind of thing. That's what I do. Oh, do you do that? Let me know. Now, this next figure is one of my favorites from the entire line. This is Boss. This is the second of the six bounty hunters from Empire Strikes Back. And I just absolutely love this figure. I think he's just super detailed. I can't imagine him coming with anything else. He comes with a gun that he should. Bossk is my favorite. I like the colors. I like the articulation. His mouth opens and closes. Like, that just, it's nuts. It's nuts that we got some garbage figures in this, and then we get this glorious figure. Now, they are re-releasing this figure in the archive line, so if you missed this, I highly recommend picking it up. This is worth it for sure. And we went from my favorite figure in the line, immediately followed by my absolute least favorite figure. This is my number one least favorite Star Wars The Black Series figure of all time. This is number 11, Emperor Palpatine. He's garbage for so many reasons. Number one, he comes with just his walking stick. Yoda came with a lightsaber, so if you wanted, you know, a prequel trilogy Yoda or not, you've got that option. He just comes with a walking stick. He could come with a lightsaber if you wanted to do like Darth Sidious or something, but he just comes with a walking stick. He doesn't even come with alternate hands. So like if you're just making him Return of the Jedi, he should at least come with like hands that have lightning coming off of them, right? So you can recreate the one thing he actually does besides just sit in his chair. Speaking of which, he can't even do that because his skirt is hard molded plastic. So even if you craft some sort of throne for him to sit in, he can't sit down because of the hard plastic skirt that he's wearing. Now, I know there are mods where you can cut this off and get him a cloth one, but I'm not doing that. I don't like this figure enough to do that. And I guess just to add insult to injury, the one accessory he does come with, the walking stick, if you put it in his hand, it doesn't even reach the ground. Like, he has to be like hunched over a little bit for it to actually reach the ground, which it's weird, it's dumb. I don't like it. This is easily the worst figure of the entire line. You can not like Last Jedi all you want and hate on those figures and make fun of Constable Vesuvio all you want, but that figure right there, for actual legitimate reasons, is the absolute worst figure. To kind of round it out, the last figure in the wave is Luke Skywalker, to kind of partner with the Han Solo in his Stormtrooper outfit. Now, these two I was super reluctant to buy. I mean, I was gonna buy them anyway, but I wasn't looking forward to buying them. I figured they were just gonna be, you know, Stormtrooper bodies with the Han and Luke head. I figured they're easy figures for Hasbro to crap out and put in a box. But what's cool about this figure is he's actually too short to be a Stormtrooper. You can see his body here. The actual waist component is actually shorter than the Han, and that's cool. Like, if you have them all staying next to each other, he actually is too short, and that's fun. He also comes with a little communicator, and that communicator does have a little spot on his belt that you can put that on, and that's kind of neat. But other than that, you know, he's got his removable helmet, and he's got his, you know, blaster. I like this one better than the Han. I like the attention to detail on this figure. I think it's really, really nice. Now, moving on to the last wave of phase two, number 13, the clone trooper captain, and he's red. He's the exact same figure as the other sergeant and the regular kind of vanilla clone trooper, but he's red now. And he's got the same weapons. And again, I'm completely okay with that because I like clone troopers. Number 14 was a surprise. This is Commander Cody. Now, I do wish they would update this figure, and I don't really want them to, honestly, but Captain Rex, the newer clone troopers, they all have removable helmets with a super nice face. I wish that he had a removable helmet, but he doesn't. It's fine. But I love his paint scheme. This is the first phase two clone trooper we got in the line. So it's kind of interesting that we got this before like a vanilla one. It's Commander Cody. But it does have a unique sculpt. He's got a unique helmet. Commander Cody probably looks different from, I would say, 90% of the other clone troopers. He comes with the exact same weapons as the other clone troopers, but the figure itself is super nice. I do wish they came with like a tiny little hologram thing with like an Emperor Palpatine to, you know, execute Order 66 or something like that. That would be neat, but I really like this figure and he looks really good with Rex for those Clone Wars fans. And if you're not a Clone Wars fan, I don't know what's wrong with you. This is IG-88, and he is the third figure to come out from the six bounty hunters from Empire Strikes Back, the ones that everyone wants, you know? He is my least favorite one. Now, I know a lot of people like him. He does have a lot of great details. The paint job, all the detail in his body is fantastic. He comes with a lot of accessories, you know? He comes with his blaster rifle, he comes with his vibro axe, he comes with a regular blaster. He can hold them all, he's got little pegs in his arms. His joints have like accordion, like rubber material, but I've heard people complain that it deteriorates and breaks. But my biggest problem with this guy is the plastic down here in his legs. is very soft and rubbery, and I've tried to fix it with hot water and straighten it out, but I couldn't. I could not get it straight. He doesn't stand up, he falls over constantly, and he's one of my least favorite figures in the entire line, which sucks because IG-88 is one of the coolest looking figures of the entire Star Wars universe. I think he actually downloads himself into the second Death Star. I don't think that's canon anymore. I don't think it ever actually was, because the book that came from was weird. But it was kind of a fun little story. And then the last normal figure to come out in phase two of Star Wars The Black Series is Princess Leia. But she's in her Bausch outfit. Now at this point, this is the second Princess Leia figure to come out, other than Jabba's Palace one. It's kind of weird, they're both from Return of the Jedi now that I think about it. But her face, in my opinion, is a lot better. I feel like it's a lot more accurate. It's still not super good, but it's a lot better than the one that they had on the other one. She's got a lot of great detail, and she's got a lot of great accessories. The helmet's great, she's got a thermal detonator, she's got her staff thing, she has a little backpack that's removable. This is a fantastic figure. She looks great as Bausch, whatever you wanna pronounce that. She looks fantastic. She's a great figure. And one thing I wanna point out, at some point, I don't wanna go back and look, but they kinda cheaped out. All these have like other languages on them, whereas they didn't in the beginning. And then there's like nothing on the back. It just has the thing. They're just like, yeah, they don't need to know anything about it. Like they had quotes and little bios, and then they were, at some point they were like, whatever, it's fine. So that's kind of weird. And that does it for the normal numbered figure release. I've got them all except for that Obi-Wan. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna end this at part one, and we're gonna move into a part two video coming out soon. And that's gonna be the exclusives and other figures, because this phase two was a little bit more than just the figures like it was in phase one. So that's all for this video. Go ahead and give me a comment down below, like, share, subscribe, all the normal YouTube stuff. Let me know what you thought of it. I like to read them. I love to respond to them. Also, I just wanna say that I was on a podcast recently called Galaxy of Toys, not to be confused with Toy Galaxy. Link in the description below, where we talked about our favorite Star Wars The Black Series figure. Since it just hit 5 years old, we wanted to kind of celebrate that. So I discussed that with some other great people, some other great Star Wars related, you know, nerdery going on, geekery going on. So if that sounds interesting to you, you can find that link down below. It'll be fun. You can hang out on a different medium, but without my face. So some people might like that better. So thanks for watching. And I'll see you later. Stick around for part, well, I guess watch out for part two. It'll come out. Bye.